Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome to another color grading tutorial, and today we're going to be working in DaVinci Resolve, and in this lesson I'm going to try to cover a little bit of skin tones. So we're going to be turning this image into this, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do that, and I'm going to also include the power grades from this tutorial on my website so you guys can download and check it out on your own. So let's get started. Today we're going to be working with the red file downloaded from the red.com from one of their sample directory over there, and I'm going to be working in a red lock film. That way you guys can follow and basically do what I'm showing and kind of figure out what exactly I'm doing, so it's going to be easier for you. So the first thing first, since this image is pretty bright, I'm not going to be worried so much about denoising it. Let me zoom in and see. We do have a little bit of chroma noise, and I'm going to take care of that just by putting 10. To me, 10 works the best. There's no reason to actually go beyond that because 10 takes care of all the chroma noise pretty well. I don't know if the YouTube lets you see it, but let me zoom in more. You can see how before and after there's a lot of little red sort of patches, and once we apply the chroma denoising, it removes it. Okay, so the first note, we're gonna call it denoise, okay? And the second note, I'm gonna do saturation. Okay, there's a couple different ways of increasing saturation. You can increase it over here in the slider, just at 100%. Or you can increase saturation in individual channels separately, which is how I like doing it. In reality, it pretty much doesn't make any difference, realistically. I think when you do it individually by channel, it gives a little bit cleaner result, but it's just my personal opinion. So we increase saturation, and right now image looks pretty good. Let's check it out before and after, and what I can see that our white balance after we applied saturation is shifted slightly. So I'm gonna bring scopes to the screen. Okay, I'm actually gonna be working with all the scopes today, the way you guys can see. And what I notice that our white balance is off by a little bit. Let me put one big vector scope over here so you guys can see. Basically this line right here indicates a good skin tone indicator. Again, it's not always perfect. Sometimes you have really weird pink or orange skin and this line shows that it's correct. I guess it's up to you by eye, but let's just kind of work today and see what's going to happen. So I'm going to create a new note, and I'm going to call this white balance, okay? And in this note, I'm just going to try to balance the proper colors. So what I'm going to do, instead of playing around with the color temperature, for example, I'm going to try to dial it exactly based on RGBs, okay? So let's see. I'm going to create a little mask over here, and I'm going to move the mask to that area that I know is supposed to be white. I'm going to turn on the highlight, and as we can see over here, this color is not really white. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the RGB parade, and as we can see that we have red here, green and blue, they're a little bit offset, and in order to get a clean white color, all of them have to be completely lined up. So let's try to do that. Now I'm gonna try to match everything precisely just like this, so our white balance is very, very accurate. Okay, so check it out. All right, that looks pretty good to my eye. Maybe a little bit more red. All right, so let's turn off the highlight and we can see the big difference that we made. So let's turn off the power window now, and our entire image gonna appear pretty well white balanced now. So as you can see, before and after, now we have in before a very nice kind of little pinkish skin, but after our white balance, the entire image sort of turned a little bit yellowish. And the reason that once we color balance properly the background, our midtones, where the faces actually is not really accurate. As we can see, that red, green, and blue very shifted. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna work exclusively in the midtones channel to sort of line them up in the same area, okay? And as we can see over here, I need to increase a little bit of, hold on, let me go back, let me turn off the Luma Mix, and I'm gonna bring up a little bit of green and a little bit of blue into the midtones. Okay, now let's check it out based on the vector scope. And as we can see, the vector scope comparing to before looks way better. We start going more towards the middle. Okay, so that looks pretty cool. Let's start adding more cinematic look into the picture. So I'm gonna increase slightly, okay, just like this, okay? And as a highlight, I really wanna sort of implement a dodge and burn look from the fashion photography into this video. And as we know, dodge and burn, I don't know if you guys are familiar with the Photoshop terminology, but basically when you burn, you make certain areas of the image darker, and when you dodge, you make it a little bit brighter. And the reason why would you do that is to create more 3D dimensional illusion of the flat picture. So for example, in our video in this case, I can see that her nose and a little bit her cheeks slightly highlighted, and I want to emphasize more to that. So I'm gonna call this current layer contrast, and I'm gonna create the next layer, and I'm gonna call this dodge and burn. And the way I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna go to the qualifier, and I'm gonna go to the Luma channel, to the luminance, and I'm gonna only be working on the most highlights of the image, which are her nose and a little bit of her cheek. I'm actually gonna take slightly a little more. Okay, I really like this. Let's make a very nice and soft selection from that. Okay, maybe move it slightly a little more back. All right, that looks really, really good. And maybe I'm gonna add a little bit more clean white, make its selection a little bit more clear. All right, so let's check it out before and after. That's our selected area. Let's turn off the highlight. And what I'm gonna do now, actually, I'm gonna increase a little bit of highlights in our image, just like this. And as you can see, we actually start getting that interesting fashion photography look. If you guys are gonna check it out in the magazines, you can actually see how under the eyes and the nose and lips and all that is being emphasized a little bit more. Now let me go back into highlight, and I'm actually gonna introduce slightly a little bit more, just like this. Okay, that way a little chin and a little bit forehead is affected by this. All right, so let me see before and after. I really like this, and what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna crank down our effect by half, so it's only slightly emphasized. Okay, I really like the look of this so far. So let's check it out before and after what we've done. Okay, that looks really, really good. And the last thing I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna add a film LUT to this, if in case we want to make it look more cinematic. Okay, so I'm gonna call this LUT. I'm gonna move this thing all the way in the end. Let me move those guys, that way we have a little bit more room to play. Okay, and I'm gonna create a new node, and I'm gonna call this LUT adjustment. And whenever you apply LUT, like 2383, it always crashes blacks, and it's always sort of spikes the saturation. And in order to counter fight that, you just have to create this kind of shape in curves to kind of bring things to more even position, just like this. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, that looks really, really good. Let's check it out before and after, before and after. So that's the first part of our color grading. And as a matter of fact, as we can see actually on our vector scope, let me zoom in a little more, we have pretty much a very healthy skin tone line. So the next thing we can do, we can create another node, and I'm gonna call this node eyes. Okay, and assuming that we're doing some kind of a fashion commercial or some product commercial, for example, I want to emphasize her eyes. So I'm going to create a costume mask just like this. Let's see, just like that. Okay, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of contrast, just a little bit. Let's see, before and after. Okay, add a little bit of contrast. Let me make this thing slightly a little smaller and add a little bit of sharpening. That way the viewer attention focuses on her eyes. Okay, you don't have to be too crazy with it because obviously it's gonna look fake if you're gonna put too much. But once I'm gonna track this, you guys are gonna see a huge difference. I don't know if she's moving back and forth since I already made my selection, so I'm just gonna track whatever we have here with all selected, and we're gonna go from there. Okay, let's check it out. Okay, the tracker looks pretty good like this. Okay, it looks nice, looks like it stays. Okay, now I'm gonna track backwards. Okay, and as we can see, our tracker moved a little bit once you started blinking, which I'm gonna go into the frame and I'm gonna add my own keyframe just like that. And I'm gonna start tracking it down when the mask started sliding, and I'm gonna start making my own keyframes to make sure that the tracker mask is where I want it to be. Okay, like that is good. And I'm just pretty much going very sloppy just to make sure that it stays in around her eye area. Okay, another mask, just like that. Okay, obviously if I would be doing this real work, I would be manually adjusting each of those, but for the tutorial, it's fine like this. Okay, just like that, around her eye. Okay, so like that looks semi-decent for our today's lesson. Okay, so let's check it out, the result from this. Okay, as we can see, okay, let me take a good frame where her eye in focus. All right, so I'm going to select this and I'm going to go on the full screen. So check it out. Before and after. Just her eye. Look at the big difference that it made. Look at this. Very, very big difference. Now we can actually see that our attention goes right in her eyes. Very, very nice. Now, for the sake of tutorial, there is no point of for me doing the second eye, but pretty much it's absolutely the same concept. You just create another node and you're doing the same effect with another eye. Now, let's finally check it out if we need to add anything more to this. So we increase the saturation, that looks pretty good. We adjusted our white balance, which is great. We added contrast, again great. We did a little bit of dodge and burn, and as you can see, it's emphasized a lot of her face details, and probably just like a little gravy on top, I'm gonna add final layer, and I'm gonna call this sharpen, and I'm just gonna introduce a little bit sharpening to the entire image. Okay, I'm gonna go here and I'm just gonna crank up a little bit of sharpening just like this. Look at the hair details from the sharpening before and after. Let me increase it so you guys can see more on through the YouTube compression. So check it out. Before and after. Before and after. Very huge difference. Okay, and let's take a look at our image before and after. Okay, and that was a little skin tone tutorial. Thank you guys so much for watching. Subscribe, and I'll see you soon.